Okay, welcome to Cooking with QueenV. Today we're gonna do crock pot chicken. Here's my crock pot, and here's my chicken. Okay, what I did was I took leg quarters that were already split. As you can see, I've already seasoned them. I put tenderizer season. I haven't added my salt and pepper, and I'm gonna add some, a little bit of seasoned salt instead of salt and pepper. Okay, so far I've already put my tenderizer on there. I put some Cajun season on there. I'm going to add a little bit of seasoned salt. And I'm sorry, the camera's all over the place. I am doing this with one hand. Okay, and while I'm seasoning the chicken, let me just tell you a little bit more about what I've already done so far. I've cut up some bell pepper, onion, celery, and some garlic, like so. Red bell pepper, green, and I have my cut up pieces of celery. Or you can do like half little stalks of celery. I've already put some in the bottom of the crock pot, as you can see. I put, I smashed up my garlic. I added some butter. And I cut up a piece of carrot. What the heck? It was only one piece. I just cut it up, but you don't necessarily have to have carrot. But I do like to have, I like the taste of carrots down in some good onion and bell peppers. When they saute together, it tastes so good. And just eat the guy. Carry it out of there by itself. However, okay, moving on. I have butter, green red bell pepper, onion. I smashed the garlic clove and I cut it up a little pieces and I placed that over there along with the butter. I have the crock pot on high just for now because I wanted that to kind of blend like together, you know, kind of simmer, kind of saute, so to speak, in a crock pot. Won't be like a skillet, but it will actually cook a little faster. So since we're in the crock pot today, things are gonna go a little slower, which is good, because once we put our chicken in there, it's gonna come together so beautifully. Now I'm going to add a little bit of seasoned salt to this side of the chicken. And I don't wanna put much, just a little bit, because we're gonna be adding other items. Usually when you add bell pepper and onions and all those great vegetable pieces, you don't want to add too much salt because that will season your food without all the excess salt. Put a little bit of black pepper. And to me, the black pepper just gives it an extra kick. I'm just kind of flip that around with my hand a little bit there. A little bit of that pepper on this side of the chicken. Okay, and I'm going to put a little bit of lemon pepper just to kind of kick up the flavor a little bit. I'm sprinkling pretty good on that both sides and kind of switch it around together. That water that's left over in the bowl, see the little excess water? That is excellent. That is just from where I rinsed off the chicken, so I didn't drain all the water off, because you're gonna need it. And it's no certain measurement, you just wanna keep that juice. Okay, that was just a little bit more lemon pepper. Okay, I'm gonna add my chicken to my crock pot. Adding my big pieces in, with the skin down. Why am I doing the skin down? Because I want that to cook down first. Gives me my oil and chicken stock. And that's just my thighs. I put three thighs and then I'm gonna add the legs. Now you may not be able to get all your chicken in there, but you know, you can always do another pot. Try to get my big pieces in there. once you get them all in. Oh, I think we're gonna be able to get them all in there. Once you get them all in, I'm gonna actually top it off with some more vegetables. My onions and bell pepper. Oh, goody, we got them all in there. That is great. And I'm just gonna take that excess water that was left over from the chicken, and I'm just gonna pour it all over. Actually, pause. Let's put in our vegetables. There's our onion. And if you want to, oh, okay. Got a blooper there. Okay. We don't necessarily need the other piece of onion, but as long as you got some onion in there. But if you want to, you can cut your onion and your bell peppers up. I just want to put them in there like this. Kind of cover them like, it's almost like a nice little veggie blanket. To me, I think it locks in the season when it's kept whole like that. Okay. And there goes my celery on top. Now, I didn't put any garlic on top. I think we have enough garlic. Garlic is such a strong piece of veggie or spice, so to speak. It is such a strong piece that you don't want to overpower your meals with it, but it's an excellent source of spice that you need, you know, even when you're cooking a lot of your foods, it's good health-wise. I'm doing two things here. And it's excellent for your bloodstream. It's excellent for your health, but it can't overpower your meals, so you don't want to take away too much from your meal. You don't want to make it garlic unless you're making a garlic meal. But I have garlic on the bottom, so later on, I'm going to flip the chicken around and just pouring the excess water and juice that was left over. I'm going to be flipping the chicken around later. And we're going to get that garlic from the bottom to the middle and to the top. Right now, I just have it covered with the onion, bell pepper, garlic, and celery. And we're going to put a couple of pieces of butter. And you can use olive oil or canola oil if you want to put on top. I'm just going to put a couple of pieces of butter on top of there. Just kind of let that melt down. Okay, and that's all we need there. Okay, and then we're going to cover it up. And we're just going to let this cook. I don't want to turn the pot back on to low, so it can take its time and cook. And we're going to come back later on and take a look at things and see how it's doing. This is an excellent meal. If you have other things to do, this is a great way to put on a pot of chicken and go and clean up or whatever you have to do. If you want to take a nap, you could do that. It won't overcook. The only thing about chicken, it does cook kind of quicker than most, quicker than red meat, of course. And you don't want to leave it in too long because you want to enjoy eating it off the bone. Sometimes if you overcook it, it will fall completely off the bone, which is nice, but you know, you can't really serve it like you want to. Then you have to come up with another way of serving it. You know, you can't serve it as whole pieces because it's falling apart. So, and sometimes you can get little bone chips caught up in that, in your meal when you let chicken stay in too long in a crock pot. However, this is going to be seasoned just great. I hope you enjoy it when yours is done. We're going to come back and take a look at everything in a little while and see how it's cooking. Be back later.